Where does this rank for you in terms of all the stories you've covered in the NFL, Peter?
I think the way I would word this is I just don't remember anything that surprised me more. I've tried to think about it because obviously people are going to ask this question. But I just don't think anything has surprised me any more than this. And having said all that, I also don't think that that it is altogether unbelievable what he did because of the kind of person that Andrew Luck is. And really, I mean, as I wrote about it today, if you look at all of the people who you know and Rich, personally, because obviously you know Andrew Luck. If you look at all the people you have known covering this game, this would be the one of the guys who would least surprise you if he walked away from football, because it's a guy who majored in architecture at Stanford. It's a guy who had his own book club. It's a guy who every time I talked to him, I mean every time, there wasn't a single time that I talked to him that we didn't have a conversation about some book that one or the other of us had read or loved. So you're asking me how surprised this is. I was absolutely shocked, obviously, but now given it a little time to have this breeze, if you ask me of the 1,700 players in football right now, who would surprise me if he walked away as great as he is long before his time, Andrew Luck would be near the top of the list of the players who it wouldn't surprise me that they would have walked away.
Well, you spoke to him on August 4th. That's the way you begin your column today, where you didn't sense at all visiting training camp from him that he was pondering anything like this. And then 15 days later, he's toast. He's done. Based on your reporting, how did this all come about?
I think the week after he spoke to me, and I was told this in my reporting this weekend, I was told that the week after I was in camp, he continued to have significant pain and maybe even more pain than he had had before this. They did a further examination, and that is when 8 days after I spoke to him, Jimmy Irsay goes on a talk show and says, now the damage is more significant than we thought. Chris Ballard, the next day, comes out and has a conference call with reporters and says, yes, the high ankle area is involved, and yes, there has been also a ligament impingement. In other words, this was not a simple calf bruise that they thought the day that I was in camp. And I can just tell you this right now, Rich. You know, that day I had conversations with both Chris Ballard and Frank Reich and also Andrew Luck. There was zero concern about this injury. Frank Reich called it child's play when I said, you got to be a little concerned about your starting quarterback not practicing. And I wouldn't say he scoffed, but he said, Peter, compared to what I went through when I first took this job last year and managing Andrew Luck's situation, this is absolute child's play. That's what he called it. So I do understand that there's a lot of people out there saying, well, this just didn't happen. This has been cooking for a long time. I have no reporting to back that up. Now, I will make this point, that when Andrew Luck says to reporters on Saturday night, I was determined after 2016 never, ever, ever to have a season like that again, never to be in pain all the time at practice and in games. Well, you know, honestly, I've heard him say things like that I'm not going through what I did in 16. I've never heard him say that if that happens again, I'm going to quit. I never heard that. And so therefore, honestly, Rich, the one thing that Chris Ballard and Frank Reich really tried to make Andrew Luck think about and think seriously about is going on that the IR with the designation to return list. You know, where after 8 weeks of the season, every team can bring two players back that they put on IR. And they tried to get Luck to do that, and Luck was insistent. He told them, and I quote, "I've made up my mind a week ago today." So at that point, Reich, I think, you know, and I'm reading into Frank Reich's, I'm reading tea leaves a little bit, but I think Reich went at that point from thinking, okay, I'm going to try everything I can to convince him to settle down and this injury will calm down and he'll be okay. From that point on, I think he felt like, I'm just going to try to support him and try to get him into the next phase of his life.
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download The Rich Eisen Show app.